All right, we're going to show you how to set up a Strike Visual inflatable arch. We have arches in different sizes and different styles. We offer continuous blower arches. Both basically mean that there's no sealed air in them. You need a blower continuously running to keep them inflated. We also have sealed air arches made out of PVC. What those are is it's a PVC material that is sealed that you need to run, inflate it, and then turn the blower off. These are great if you don't have a power supply or source. You can take them and move them around, leave them in vent. And then we have one that's kind of an in-between. It's a sealed air bladder that we put a sleeve on. What's great about that is you have a full dye sublimation printing of the continuous blowers, but then you have the sealed air capabilities. In each of these, we offer different sizes, starting from 10 feet, and that's measured by the base width of the arch, so 10 feet, and then every 5 feet up, so 15, 20, up to 50 feet wide. We offer these in different sizes. Today, we're gonna set up the 20-foot continuous blower dye sublimated arch. So first off, when you buy one of these, you'll receive it in a bag similar to this. Have a short visual patch and maybe a piece of artwork on there. Just need to unzip the bag. Inside the bag really should just be the arch and an anchor kit. Pull it out, set it aside. This one has an internal blower. We have two different options depending on the size of the arch. The bigger you get, the bigger the blower you need. So internal blowers are already mounted in there when you get them. 10 foot, 15 foot, 20 foot could have this. And then 20 foot and above, we would do an external blower. That would come in a separate package. Once you have the arch fully out of the bag, you kind of want to open it up, spread it out. Do this just by laying it out on the grass. This is a 20 foot arch and an internal blower. So you're going to have the power cord that actually comes out of the zipper. On each of the legs or ends of the arch, you're gonna have two zippers with Velcro on them. You wanna make sure that when you're sealing them up to inflate them, you zip them and Velcro it down shut. This offers two layers of protection to kind of help keep the air in, keep it inflated. And then you just wanna plug it in. So we'll get it zipped shut, Velcro it shut. Leaving the cord on the internals just hanging out the side. And the other end. The reason it's on both ends is to help for ease of deflating the arch. When you're done, ready to take it down, open up both ends and air comes out really quickly. Okay, once you have both those sealed up, kind of lay it out, give it room to blow up, make sure you have plenty of room for it to inflate, and then just plug it in. While inflating, you want to make sure that nothing is covering the fan or the blower, so it allows plenty of airflow to come in and inflate it up. Just make sure it's not twisted or kinked or anything as well when you're blowing it up. There's plenty of airflow and good. Okay, now it's fully inflated. We want to keep the fan blowing in this case, as it's a continuous blower and it's not sealed air, it would just deflate if we unplugged it. So we just kind of set it up. You can do this, usually helps with two people. I can do it on my own. Included with each arch kit, you're gonna get one of the bar anchor kits. What's included in here, zip, open it up. It has care instructions, a little bit of material for any issues you may have. It has four sets of rope that you can use to tie down on the tie downs if it's really windy. And it's got four of these ground stakes. These stakes we're gonna use to kind of go through the D-rings on the base to hold it in place. Like I said, you can also use them to tie up rope on the different tie up places like you see here. Tie these off, hold it down, anchor it down. The other D-rings you'll find on it are these. These are used for hanging banners or wraparound banners. You can do them in two different ways. You can hang banners from it, or you can wrap it around and secure them through the D-rings there. So when securing it down, you use these ground stakes. There's D-rings, two on each side on opposite ends. You just want to take it, put it through the D-ring, and then you can just use a hammer, hammer it into the ground. Just like that. You'll do that on all four, two on each side of the legs. help keep it anchored to the ground from tipping to the side. Again, in really windy situations, you want to use the rope to tie off on the sides to keep it from tipping side to side. And you can use ground stakes to enter those in as well. If you're not in a grass area where you can't use the ground stakes, a couple other good options we offer are sandbags or plate weights. Plate weights are going to be the best, the heaviest, 30 pound weight. Basically, you can just tie off the rope onto these and set them out on the asphalt, concrete, pavement, wherever you are, to anchor them down. So the different options are, this is a continuous blower with an internal blower. So you have the internal fan or blower built right into the arch. You want to keep it plugged in and running the whole time you have the arch up. If not, it'll lose its air and deflate. The other options we can do are the sealed air. Those are great. They're a great alternative with no power source. You don't have the ability to have it plugged in during your event. So what you would do is, it's a smaller blower, just an air compressor. Yeah, there's a valve, you connect it in, blow it up. There we have a pressure relief valve included on the arch, so you can't pop it. We're not gonna make it, we're trying to make it as easy for you as possible, so you can't overinflate it. When it's full, it'll just blow off air into the pressure relief valve. When you're done blowing it up, just turn the blower off, put the cap over the valve, use it for your event. When the event's over with, simply just do it in reverse, undo the cap. There's a little knob in there, you just compress and do it a quarter turn, and that quarter turn will then release the air. Just let it deflate on its own. So in order to take these down, it's as simple for the continuous blower. All you're going to do is just disconnect the power, and it's going to start to lose its air. So already it's going to start losing its air and kind of falling down. You may want to help it down so it doesn't fall on anything or anyone. So once it's down, you want to unzip the base to allow the air out even quicker. So we Velcroed and zipped it up, just undo it the opposite way. This gives it a big opening for the air to exit out. Do this on both sides. You can help it by pushing the air out, rolling it up, but if you just leave it over time, it'll just let its air out on its own. Okay, so when you're ready to fold it up, you just want to kind of roll it together. Try and keep it as tight as possible. There's no perfect way to do it, but if you just kind of fold it on top of itself, push the air out the bottom of the legs where you have the opening, it seems to help a lot. Just squeeze it to let the air out, and then you can put it back in your bag. Zip it up, and you're all done.